when I was in school, I went to a French culinary school, and every day was mirepoix this and mirepoix that, mirepoix. That's all they were talking about, right? It was every day mirepoix. Useful. However, I guess I should tell you what mirepoix is, right? It's your starter. It's your beginning to everything. So basically it's onions, carrots, and celery. It's everything, right? It works. It does. Me personally, my mirepoix are onions, peppers, and garlic. Always. I feel like if you always have them in your fridge, literally it should just be like you should go to the grocery store, go to the market, farmer's market, whatever you're doing, go there, look for your onions, look for your peppers, that should be the first thing you do. You should always have them. Always. It's the kind of thing like they'll sit in your fridge. When you want to throw something together really fast, you throw them in. You want to make a steak, grill some onions. You want to make a sauce, you can literally make a sauce with those four things. I mean, and it's that easy.
Does the color of the peppers matter?
To you, maybe not. I can tell. But yeah, since you want to be a great cook, I would say it matters. She wants to be a great cook. You can't at all. She wants to be a great cook.
Don't lie on camera.
Can you cook?
I can cook some stuff. I can.
That's like me saying I can sing some things. It doesn't really make any sense.
It does.
You can, you can. Anyway, I'm excited to help her. So this is, okay, so I should tell you what we're making, right? Cheese. We're gonna make soup. And I figured since Thanksgiving is coming, and everyone's gonna have a bird carcass in their fridge soon, be a good little moment to share with you. I love soup. I absolutely love it. It's healthy. It's like super flavorful. And it's wonderful. And it's something you can make a lot of and stick it in the fridge and not think about it. So I like that. How absolutely delicious it comes out. I don't know if you're guilty of this, but sometimes I'll go to the grocery store and I'll see something and I'm like, ooh, yes. Why did I buy that? Why did I do that? Why? Lord knows I have no time this week at all. I'm not gonna be making nothing fancy, right? I'm working and I'm like, I'm busy and I've got my little one and we're doing this and he's got soccer and I've got photo shoots and it's like, I really don't have time to go making some extravagant thing. So then what ends up happening is it sits in the fridge. It starts to get soft, which I hate, right? And then I feel horrible because then I don't want to throw it away. First of all, I hate waste. There's no reason to waste, right? Like, why? Like, you can make stuff with it. Use it. If you're going to buy it, use it, right? So that's the idea. So what I'm saying is when I make the mistake of buying stuff and I don't have time to cook it, by the end of the week, I'm like, dang it, what do? Make a soup. Because it's going to be mushy anyway, right? So that way you don't lose it and it's delicious. Make sense?
Yes.
Yeah. People are always like chicken noodle soup and then it's like this yellow broth with like white chicken breast and some weird like, why is that delicious? It's not. So, sorry, that's how your mom makes chicken noodle soup. I'm just saying. We are going to make an amazing chicken noodle soup. Like, so good. Anything you've got coming down, it's going to work. It's true. It's so true. I guarantee it. Okay. So check this out. Literally, it's a gigantic, you can't even get in here, can you? You can't even see it, she's so small. You're so short. There you go. So it's literally just water, okay? Just water. You add salt to your water. I like kosher salt. I don't like iodized salt, it's too salty, and it's like processed weird. And I feel like it's why a lot of people have high blood pressure.
Kosher salt.
It's true. So, kosher salt is really good stuff. Sea salt, you know, taste it. Salts have different flavor, people don't realize that. So check it out. This is gonna help bring your water to a boil, right? So we wanna get this going. We've got our heat on high. We're gonna let that do what it's gonna do. And I'm just gonna start going in the fridge and seeing what else I have in there that I didn't get to cook this week. I'm gonna toss it in there. Don't judge and don't make a weird face. Here's the thing. Look at this. Don't get my nails, your nails. I'm like, I also don't have time for a problem anymore. I'm looking a little bit rough right now. It doesn't matter, I'm still a great cook. Okay, so look. Look at this. I just took off the ugly bit, right? And look. Gorgeous. Look at that. It's perfect, right?
Yep.
Perfectly good nutrients that one of you would have thrown away. Here's the other thing too though that you'll learn. If you buy organic stuff, it doesn't last as long. There's a reason for that. I lied to you about this is true. I bought some hot dog buns and then I went on tour. You know how long we were gone for. It was like 6 months. I came home and they were perfect. They were perfect.
Why?
They're like soft and lush and... Why? Because they're trying to kill us. That's why. There's no reason why bread should last for 6 months if it's not in the freezer. That is outrageous. And the thing is, I'm not one of those people that's like super precious about like, everything has to be organic. Like, I'm not. That's annoying. It's like, first of all, do your research. Like, at the end of the day, there's really not... It's debatable if there's really any such thing. Like, you have to put something on it, right? It's about finding balance, you know? Like, get your bread from a bakery. Better if you can, because listen, if someone told me that like all this food with the preservatives is going to preserve me longer, I'd be like, please, more preservatives, pesticides over here, please. But it doesn't. It works on the food and it doesn't work on us. Instead, it kills us. Don't eat it. Go to your farmer's market, find out what's local. We live in a big great country, and well, at least there's a lot of farmland. I'm like, we've got that. And listen, don't freaking kill yourself. If you're running late, okay, it doesn't happen. Try better next time. Like, I still prefer white toilet paper, I'm just saying. Have you seen that? Natural toilet paper?
Oh, no, I haven't heard of that.
Yeah, well.
What is it made of? Like, leaves?
I mean, it's made of the same, no. No, but it's all, like, not dyed and, like, I tried that in diapers, too, like, the natural diapers. It was leaking everywhere. Sometimes you need a little manufacturing going on. It's about finding balance. The ugly bits are gone. We'll rinse these suckers off and they're gonna be perfect.
So I noticed that on the cooking show, it's all about wine, but on this show, it's a beer moment.
That's hilarious. I drink beer and I drink wine. I love good beer and I love good wine.
Tonight, yeah. It's all about beer.
Yeah. Cheers. Ready? Okay, great. So, here's the thing. Again, we talked about waste, right? So you take your turkey, chicken, whatever carcass, sound crazy? Take that, whatever's on it, it doesn't matter if it's like, you literally cleaned it so it looks like jewelry, okay, I don't care. Take that bone and stick it in your pot of water, right?
Right.
Usually that's how you make stock, that's the beginning of stock. Okay, which as we know will flavor everything magnificently as opposed to just water, right? We talk about mirepoix, this is my mirepoix, onions. And the beauty of this too is that you don't have to chop everything crazy, so, well, you know, you don't have to crack. And just start dumping all of your veg in there. I love cutting a fresh garlic head and like all that. But you know when I do like all my parties and stuff? I can't.
Too much.
First of all, because you're going to cook this for so long, like this is one of those things you cook, go watch some Ratchet TV, come back, read the word, balance. This will still be doing what it's doing. So it's a lot of water here right now, but here's the key too. This is going to cook down. It's called reducing. This will reduce, which means that like it'll evaporate. You want it to, like I said, this is going to like, all these vegetables are going to break down. It's going to make like this gorgeous broth. Eventually at the end, well, no, I'm lying, that's not true. What I'll do is, what I usually do, because like, if I'm making a big pot like this, if you're making just a pot for yourself, it's one thing. But like I said, I like to make it for the family and make it so that I can put it in their freezer or their refrigerator for next week or whatever. I'll boil my pasta separate and then add it as I like serve the soup. Does that make sense? Because what happens is the pasta, if you put the pasta in here right now, or like, you know, whatever, towards the end, when you're boiling the pasta, all the starch in the pasta and the pasta soak up all the broth, so you have like wet noodles. I know some chicks like that. We don't like those. Now is the fun part, we're gonna season, right? Now, some coarsely ground black pepper. Did this?
Well, it's not freaking.
I love it. So good. I got this when I was in
Budapest. I was just about to ask you, where do you get smoked paprika?
Okay, well, first of all, you can find it anywhere, but I got that one when we were in Budapest.
Ew.
You were with me in Budapest.
Yeah.
Yeah, so that's where paprika comes from, by the way. You don't want the powdered garlic, you want granulated garlic, right? So think about this, like, ever had, like, like dried mango or dried pineapple?
Yes.
Right? Like, how much more potent is the flavor?
It's right? Very strong, yeah.
So you suck out the moisture, and then all you have is flavor, right? So that's the idea with dried seasonings. It's the same concept. Like, you want to be, like, garlic powder, and you might put fresh garlic in there. Also put a little garlic powder because it's more potent, and again, it gives body and girth and all kinds of good things that we like. This is onion powder.
So these are still those, like, essential things that every person who wants to be a cook should have.
Yeah, you should have paprika, you should have fresh
smoked
pepper.
Paprika?
It doesn't have to be smoked. I like smoked. You can just be paprika. I personally like smoked. It has a lot of body. You should always have a great olive oil. You should have granulated garlic, granulated onion. Those are kind of your, like, solid core. It's like your little black dress. It's like your great black pump. It's like your everyday bag. Gotta have it. It's bare necessity. This is dry time. It's dried. It was fresh, and then I dried it. So I put black pepper, but spicy doesn't mean, like, all one thing. There's many different kinds of spice. I want to teach you how to cook. I don't want to give you a bunch of recipes because at the end of the day, like, anybody can do that. I want to teach you how to cook. It's not about, like, do I remember how to make it. I know the principles and the properties that make sense to me. That's why I know how to cook. It's not the fact
true,
that, like,
true.
I have a bunch of recipes. I can turn them into recipes, but, like, I know what makes sense. I'm like, coconut would be great. Put that in, because I know what coconut does. Sit in your kitchen sometimes, and the funny thing is, as a chef, I still do this, and in school, even before graduating, a lot of our tests, actually, were, like, taste and like, smell, like, sense tests. Because I think it's, like, you have to know what something's going to do. What does it do? You wear heels because you know what they're going to do. You know what you're going to feel like. You know if you're going to respond to them. You know what they do to you, right? So I think it's the same thing with food. It's, like, what does it do? What does oregano do when you put it in something? Does it make a difference if it's fresh, if it's dry? What does it do? To this day, every time I put in nutmeg or cumin, I smell it. Because they're very strong seasonings and they can totally overpower something to the point where it will ruin what you're making. Mm-hmm. So I know what they taste like and I know what they're gonna do, but I smell it just to give myself a mental reminder how much to put in. Then I wanna teach you how to cook. I don't wanna give you a bunch of recipes. I want you to understand what this is. What, do you know what I mean? Like, what, there are certain things that we know. It's like, this is always gonna help. You add sugar to yeast, you know that it's gonna help it open up.
Right.
You know what I mean? It's like certain things that I just, that you know, it's just, that's just, that's what's gonna happen. Mm-hmm. Once you know those things, that's when you can play. When you were teaching me how to play drums.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Yeah.
Like, I wanna do all these fills and go crazy. You're like, no.
Right. No, it's true.
Learn.
I see. No, I know exactly what you're saying. If you know the basics, then it's easy to
get crazy. Go do whatever you want to do, but you can't get crazy first. And then, like, you can't play. Right? And I had to learn the very easy, like, and then I was like, oh, I'm killing you. Right? Garlic, cilantro, parsley, peppers, onions. Grind it all down in your jar or in your. Really?
I need to rest my arm.
Are you leaning on the oregano?
I need to put my, this camera's heavy.
Easy breezy. Common sense. When it's done, it's done.